Hello everyone, I am happy to see you all. Today we are going to see managerial economics. In that, I am going to cover the topics demand, demand schedule and determinants of demand. Now we'll move on to the session.
Demand. The demand refers to the consumer's desire to purchase goods and services and willingness to pay. Next, we'll see the demand schedule. The demand schedule is a list of quantities of a commodity purchased by a consumer at different prices. Here, the table represents when prices decreases, the quantity demanded will be increased. We can see the diagram. There will be x-axis represent quantity demanded, y-axis represent price, DD is a demand curve. Here the prices decreasing, the quantity demanded will be increasing. Next we'll see the determinants of demand. The determinants of demand is 5 determinants of demand we are having. So here QD is equal to F. QD is a quantity demanded. F is function. So F represents, these are all the functions. The function, the first function is price of goods or services. The second one, income of buyers. The third one, prices of related goods or services. The fourth one, taste of consumers. So the last one, expectations. Now, we'll see one by one. The first one, price of goods or services. The law of demand states that when prices rise, the quantity of demand falls. That also means that when prices drop, demand will grow. We'll move on to the second determinant, the income of the buyers. When income rises, so will the quantity demanded. When income falls, so will demand. But if your income doubles, you won't always buy twice as much of your particular goods or services. We'll take an example of salt. When our income raises also, we'll not demand more salt. Then the third point is prices of related goods or services. The price of complementary goods or services raises the cost of using the product you demand. So, you will want less. The opposite reaction occurs when the price of a substitute raises. People will want more of the goods or service and less of its substitutes. Then we'll move on to the fourth determinant, taste of customers. When the public desires, emotions or preferences change in favor of your product, so does the quantity demanded. Likewise, when taste go against it, that depresses the amount demanded. So we'll move on to the last topic, that is the last determinant, the fifth one, expectation. Here, when the people expect that the value of something will rise, they demand more of it. The customer satisfaction will be reflects the expectations and experiences of the customer. So these are all the 5 determinants. So price of goods or services and income of buyers, prices of related goods or services, taste of customers and expectations. So far we discussed these things. Thank you.